Joseph Reading Aiki. Ah, is that relevant to the topic of my parole? Alright, I was convicted on 41 counts of manslaughter, but it wasn't really my fault. It just got out of hand. Well, I've been working on my anger. Recently, I stopped considering killing my cellmate, seeing him as a whole person and all that. Oh, and I've been meditating. I take classes every Tuesday. You know, I really thought about this question. And honestly, I'm gonna start another church. And this time, I'm gonna really try. The first time wasn't of God. It wasn't really for anything. Maybe my ego. My uncle has an empty farmhouse. That's gonna be home base. Mark my word, there's gonna be healing and pure worship. I'm really gonna listen to God this time. This time, for sure. God hasn't talked to me much. I think he's angry. I don't think he likes me, seeing Dr. Sims. It was the same way when I was a kid. I was a normal kid, with normal parents. We went to church on Sunday. I went to public school on weekdays and woke up early for Saturday cartoons. I had sleepovers, nerf wars, friends. I had to attend my grandparents' funeral. I was in the room when my sister was born. I was normal. Nothing, I mean nothing out of the ordinary happened. If you think you'll prove something by this question, that's not going to happen. Like I said, my conviction is based on pure fiction. You mean when started talk to me? You people always twist things up. I can pinpoint an exact moment. I feel like God's always talk to me. It just took me time to understand him. College was the first time I understood him. I was sitting in the cafeteria enjoying my lunch. What? Yes, but I don't see why it matters. Okay, I was sitting in the cafeteria and I heard a voice. It was deep, so deep. The noise of the cafeteria dropped to nothing. Then my forehead felt his voice. Drop your net, my child! Be a fisher of men! I woke up in the hospital. My eyes could see so many colors. All these things I was worried about, they seemed so still now. I knew. In that moment, I would be a great prophet. The scales fell from my eyes. My soul had a uniform and singular goal. I was to find the weak and lost and bring them home. My church would have the rejects, the broken, the cursed aside. I wouldn't rest till the unloved would be filled, overflowed with his love. You want me to get angry, huh? Asking these ignorant questions. You expect me to be this crazy guy. Give you wackadoodle answers. Affirm that you are normal? You are not normal! It's not normal to cast aside the aisle. To let your broken brothers and sisters struggle. How many homeless did you pass by today? How many of the men and women in this prison have broken minds? How many were hurt as the kids? Why do they even have to be special? Why can't they have faith and that's enough? The truth is, and what you can't see is, what you so hate about the world. Is that the cast aside are the only ones who truly know what God's love feels like? They truly have to rely on him. You, normal people, only deep on God when it's convenient. When your car breaks down, when you're sick, the cast aside needs him every day. They can't even leave the house without his strength. How? Your minds are too small to really understand what happened. I helped those people ascend. God said he wanted them to join him, and I was complied. It wasn't a mass suicide. It was allowing his angels to return home. You weren't there. You didn't see how relieved they were. They went through so much pain. Their bodies were mangled, beaten, broken. Their minds were full of pain and hurt. It wasn't God that did that. That was you and your sins. You couldn't let them live their natural lives. You forced them to take medications and to restrict them. You've wrung their minds into a complacent state, put them in box. I set them free. I let them live. I would do it again if I could. Hurry it up. My work isn't done. I can't just leave now. There are more to help. There are more to find, more to save. My church will come back better and stronger than ever. He's never and never will tell me to do such a thing. I just do. Stop putting God in quotes. I'm not crazy. I'm not. Stop. You don't know what you are talking about. You are so in the world you couldn't even understand who you're talking to. I am a prophet from the Lord. I shall save the weak. You will never, never stop me. No, no, stop. No, 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 stop, no!